The University of Calgary Libraries and Cultural Resources presents Skills for Systematic Reviews. Endnote, importing an RIS file from Medline. This video will show you how to import search results from an RIS file. In particular, in this video, I'm going to be importing a set of Medline search results that were exported in an earlier video from Medline. And they were saved as an RIS file. I just also want to note that this video is showing you how to import your first set of database search results. And I just mentioned that because importing your first set of database search results and your later set of search results is just a slightly different process. So that will be another video with using CINAHL as an example to show that. So the first step to importing my Medline search results is to select the import icon, which is this downward pointing arrow. And the import file dialog box should open, and then just select choose to find the file we wish to import. So I called mine Medline results, so it's easy to find. And you might just want to double check that it is indeed an RIS file, just under type here. Mine is, so I'm good to go. So I'm just going to click open. And then beside import option, just make sure you've selected reference manager, RIS. And in duplicates, we're going to leave it set to import all because we don't want any duplicates being identified and removed at this point. And text translation, we're just going to leave set to no translation. So that's good to go. And we're just going to click import. Now the actual importing may take a couple minutes, especially if it's a larger file. So just be patient. All right, so there we go. We can see that the search results have been imported into EndNote. At this stage, it's good to just double check that the number of results you exported from your database are the number of results that have now shown up inside of EndNote. So I'm just going to double check. 424 is the number that I exported, so I'm good to go. Now we're almost done, but first, we need to move all of these search results into the Medline folder that we created earlier. So I'm just going to select one of the results and then hit Control A to select all. And I'm just going to drag them into that Medline folder. And then the last step, I'm going to open my Medline folder and make sure to click the database folder for this last step, especially if it's not the first database that you've imported. And what we're going to do now is we're going to add the name of the database into the name of database field because right now it's empty. And this is because later when we're identifying and removing external duplicates, this is the only way we're going to be able to tell which database the duplicate came from. So to do this step, we're just going to select all again. So by clicking one of the references and then Control A to select all, and then we're going to click Tools and we're going to click Change Move Copy Fields. At this point, I just want to note, you may be tempted to go under References and click Edit References. This will prompt you to edit each of your references individually, and it kind of crashes EndNote because it opens a million windows all at once. So make sure to go to Tools and then down to Change Move Copy Fields. We're going to click that. And then we're just going to stay in this Change Fields tab. And then select a field, we're going to go down and we're going to find our name of database, which is way down at the bottom here. And I accidentally clicked Database Provider, so make sure you select Name of Database. And we're going to select Replace Whole Field With. We're just going to type in Medline, or whichever database you are currently importing. And then we're just going to hit OK. And you're going to get a dialog box just asking if you're sure you want to do this. And I am, so hit OK. And again, this changing fields will probably take a minute, longer if you have lots of results. Okay. All right, and so as we can see, Medline is now in the name of database fields. And I also just want to point out this isn't just within the Medline folder. If we go back to all references, we can see it was changed here for all of the records. And you're done. So the next step is now to identify and remove any internal duplicates. And it's important to do this before importing any more search results. It was adapted with permission from Basic Training and Systematic Reviews and Meta-Analyses, Managing Results from the Research Medical Library at the University of Texas MD Anderson Cancer Center and funded by the University of Calgary Teaching and Learning Grant. For more information about systematic reviews, please see the University of Calgary LibGuide.